Greetings and welcome to the Introduction to Astronomy. One of the things that I like to do in each of my introductory astronomy classes is to begin the class with the astronomy picture of the day from the NASA website that is apod.nasa.gov/apod. And today's picture for June the 22nd of 2020, well, it is titled Moon Mountains Magnified During Ring of Fire Eclipse. So what do we see here? Well, this is an image or set of images taken during the annular solar eclipse that occurred yesterday. So if you were in the eastern hemisphere, you would have been able to see, and I should say, and in the right location, you would have been able to see an annular eclipse of the sun. Now, a solar eclipse occurs when the moon passes in front of the sun. A total solar eclipse occurs when the moon passes completely in front of the sun and blocks it out entirely. This was an annular solar eclipse for annulus or ring, and that happens when the moon passes in front of the sun but is not quite big enough to block out the entire sun. This occurs when the moon is at its furthest distance from the Earth, called apogee. So when it is its furthest distance, it appears a little bit smaller, and it's not quite big enough to be able to block out the sun. So the central image here is the moon in the center with the ring of sunlight around it. Now, how about all of the other small rings there? Well, those are to show and to demonstrate the surface features of the moon and how irregular the sides are. If you notice, the two sides do not appear the same. So one occurred at the beginning of the eclipse and the other at the end of the eclipse, as sunlight would still sneak through the mountains. So mountains on the moon and valleys, the mountains would be a little taller and block out the sunlight, whereas the valleys, sunlight could still sneak through. So if the moon were a perfectly smooth sphere, we would not get this effect, and the eclipse would just occur all over the moon at the same time. However, because the moon is not perfectly smooth, we can see these kind of things which tell us about the structures right around the edge of the moon as the eclipse occurs. So we can kind of see what was happening there with the eclipse. Now, if you were not able to see this eclipse, we do have more eclipses coming up this year, and there will be another eclipse coming up. There will be another annular eclipse occurring that will be visible in the northern hemisphere, primarily up in Canada, so very higher regions of the Earth. And of course, there will be more eclipses occurring. There are eclipses that occur every year. And another eclipse will be a total solar eclipse that will be visible in the Antarctic regions towards the end of this year. Now, eclipses will occur about 6 months apart, because those are the times when the sun, moon, and Earth will all be in a straight line, and that is what is required in order to get an eclipse. The orbits are actually slightly tilted by about 5 degrees, and that means that most of the time the moon will not pass directly in front of the sun. It will pass above or below the sun, and we will not see an eclipse. But during those eclipse seasons, we will be able to see an eclipse when the moon will then line up and pass directly in front of the sun. So that was our picture of the day for June the 22nd of 2020. It was titled Moon Mountains Magnified During Ring of Fire Eclipse. We'll be back again tomorrow for the next picture, previewed to be X-raying the sky. So we'll see what that is about tomorrow. And until then, have a great day, everyone, and I will see you in class.